Hello class, this is Ms. Augustine, and today you're going to be doing a lab, line emission spectra lab, and you should have a handout that my substitute teacher hopefully gave to you. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be copying down what we see, and we're going to be using some spectroscopes. So to begin, let me go through some terms. What you're observing today are called atomic emission spectra. And it's a pattern of lines and frequencies obtained when you pass light emitted by atoms of an element through a prism. So we're going to have light sources that have gaseous elements in a tube, in a vacuum tube, and then you're going to look at the light, and you're going to look at the light through a spectroscope that allows you to put it through a prism, and then you're going to see a pattern of lines, and that is the so-called atomic emission spectra. So some more terms. When we're talking about light, you haven't gotten the notes perhaps yet for this, or maybe you have depending on which period of the day you see me, but we're going to be doing notes about light, and we're going to talk about the frequency, which the Greek letter nu is used for frequency, and that's the number of wave cycles that pass a given point per unit of time, so cycles per second, and we're going to talk about the wavelength, which is, again, a measurement of length, and that is the Greek letter lambda is used, and that is defined as the distance between the adjacent crests of a wave. And some more background information. Electrons in an atom can be excited, and they jump from one energy level to another by adding energy to them. So you've learned about energy levels in atoms, and you've learned about 1s and 2s and 2p and all of that stuff. So atoms can absorb energy, and when they do, the electrons get excited and they jump up to a different energy level. And then eventually they fall back down to a lower energy level. And when they do that, they release that same amount of energy as electromagnetic radiation and what we see as light. So each electron loses an exact amount of energy that's known as a quantum of energy, and those exact amounts of energy can be divided up into their individual lines using a prism. So when you see the light viewed through a prism, you see a pattern of lines, and the lines are arranged according to different wavelengths. So the atomic emission spectrum is the pattern of wavelengths of light released by an element, and the measurement for wavelength is in something called nanometers, which are 10 to the minus 9 meters, so billionth of a meter. So the formulas that we use, there's two formulas which we'll spend more time on later this week in our notes. The frequency of a quantum of light times its wavelength is equal to the speed of light, and the letter that we use for the speed of light is lowercase c. So the frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional to the speed of light, and the speed of light in a vacuum is 3 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And the equation that we'll use, which you'll see in your lab handout, is that c is equal to frequency times wavelength. We can also calculate the energy of that photon of light, and it's calculated by multiplying the frequency, again, Greek letter nu, by another constant, and this one is Planck's constant, and the letter for Planck's constant that we use is H. And Planck's constant is kind of a funny constant. It's 6.63 times 10 to the minus 34 joules times seconds. Joules is a unit that's used for energy, and seconds, obviously, is a unit for time, and the equation is E equals H times nu. Now, again, we're going to spend more time on this later this week, but it's in your lab handout, so I'm highlighting it here. So the objective of this lab is to use a spectroscope to view the atomic emission spectra of various elements. So you're going to be handed out these little spectroscopes, and you're also going to be seeing at the lab benches these high energy light sources. Now you'll notice in the picture it has danger up here. Do not put near water. Do not touch it because these are high voltage. So they should be set up 2 per lab station, and there's a little switch on the side over here, and you'll click that on and it will glow like this. And then you're going to use your spectroscope to view it. And the spectroscope has a place for you to look with your eye over here. And then there's a slit, a little tiny slit over here. And then in this region here, when you're looking through it, you'll see a little scale that kind of looks like this. And it's got numbers that correspond to wavelength. And basically, you're going to be looking to see the pretty lines that show up when you look at these light sources. So you're going to copy and record the line spectra of 7 elements that you observe. And you're going to do the best you can using colored pencils to copy what you see. And you may observe the elements in any order, but not more than 4 people at a lab bench at a time for safety reasons. So you're going to have to be bright about this and organize yourselves so that you can all cycle through all of the lab stations and observe what you need to see. Now, you want to make sure that you copy the 4 elements listed in the lab handout plus 3 additional elements. Later this week, we're going to calculate the frequency and energy of various lines in 4 of the element spectra, and those are listed in the handout. Don't worry about those now. You're going to be using the wavelengths that are listed to do some calculations. But for today, all I want you to do is to copy down the bright line spectra. Now, how do you use the spectroscope? Well, you need to look through the spectroscope and line it up so that you can see the light source through the slit. And then you shift it slightly, either to the left or the right, depending, until you see a pattern of lines appear above the scale. So this is a little diagram here of your spectroscope, and you're going to look in here at this small end. And then what you're looking through is you're going to look through and find the slit, and you're going to try to line up the bulb that you see with the slit. And when you do that, sometimes you have to just slightly shift it a little bit. All of a sudden, you'll see this pattern of lines show up with the scale. So you'll see a series of bright lines that will be different for each element. And if you take the spectroscopes and look out the window, if the sun is shining today, and I don't know if that's the case, you'll see a continuous blur because sunlight is all of the visible spectrum. But then if you take it and you try to look at one of the fluorescent lights, you'll see blocks of light. And finally, when you look at the various bulbs that are positioned around the room, you'll see patterns of lines. So you'll notice here for hydrogen, you only see 4 lines. For neon, you'll see considerably more lines, and for some of the other elements, and I don't believe we have iron, but I think we have bromine and argon, you'll see lots and lots of lines. So you're going to try to copy down as best you can the lines that you observe. I also like to point out that it's super helpful if you hold the spectroscope level while you're looking at the light source. So you want to try to not angle it up or down. You want to try to be as level as you can as you're observing. Items to keep in mind. First off, the small slit of the spectroscope must be in line with the bulb in order to see the line spectrum. And again, it's super important for it to be level. So you want to try to level the spectroscope so that you're not angled. You want it to be parallel to the floor. And again, what you'll see then, if this is the light source, is you'll eventually see lines showing up in your scale in the spectroscope. And you'll need to close both the blinds and the lights in the classroom in order to do that, because it's really hard to see the bright line spectra unless the room is dark. If it's a sunny day, it can be very challenging. Other items to keep in mind. You're going to use the colored pencils to copy the spectrum of each element that you observe, and make sure that when you're looking at hydrogen, you copy its spectrum down in the spot that's given to you for copying down hydrogen, and so on and so forth. You don't have to line up your drawings with the scale and the spectroscope, so do the best you can as far as showing the colored lines as you see them. The light sources are high voltage, That means you are not going to try to touch the bulbs. You'll get hurt. You're also going to keep the light sources away from the edges of the lab benches and from the sink, because obviously you could get electrocuted. And finally, you do not need to wear your goggles for this experiment. So, this is Ms. Augustine signing off. Your mission today is to try to copy down as best you can, using colored pencils, the bright line spectra of 7 elements, 4 that are written in the lab handout, and 3 additional ones, and there should be, I'm trying to say, 10 or 12 different light sources. So again, try to observe the 7 that you're asked to, 4 that are written, and 3 additional ones. And we will work on doing the calculations later in the week. And then there's a spot on the lab handout for you to write some conclusions about what you've observed today. This is Ms. Augustine signing off.